Hello, this is Global Family in Fukushima. Well, just me at least. Today I'm coming to you from hospital. Dun, dun, dun. The reason being is that today is Monday, I will have a small tumor removed from my lung, which sounds very serious, but there's a few things you should know first. One, in Japan, we have something called 健康診断, which is like a yearly health checkup, usually done by your workplace. I had my checkup in May. I got the results in June. It is now July. In my checkup, I had a chest x-ray, which came back a little bit iffy. And when I got checked out, it turns out I have a small lump on my lung, but they think it's probably benign, but they have to take it out to be sure. Either way, even if it is cancerous, it's only like level one, so it should be cured by removal as well. So things to be thankful for. Japan has these yearly health checkups, so it didn't have to cause me any symptoms for us to find it first. Second thing is like I said, the doctors think it's benign, but it did get there kind of fast because we have these checkups yearly. I missed mine last year because I was having a baby, but I had one the year before and there was nothing there. So it must have appeared in the past 2 years. So the decision was made to remove it. So very interesting being in hospital in Japan. So I've had some experience, not so much myself. I was in hospital once when I was a kid, but I don't really remember it. And I've given birth in Japan, but I've never been admitted to hospital for anything like this in Japan. But my family have spent some time in hospital and with surgeries and so on when I was younger, so I do have some knowledge of Australian hospital system, especially since also my mom is a nurse. So my mom was a little bit confused, as was I, that I was admitted to hospital 5 days. Five. Before my surgery, which I'm sure many people would find very interesting. I'm sorry, my hands are shaking. And we weren't really sure why at first, but once I was admitted, it sort of became clear. There's a lot of things they do to prepare you for surgery here if they have the time. One thing is that I'm doing breathing training because it's my lungs. I have to do breathing training every day. So I see a rehabilitation nurse every day, and we do breathing practice and also exercise together to help my lungs prepare and also get stronger before I go into surgery. The other thing I did is the anesthetist came and saw me on Saturday, I think, to double check with me about everything and for me to sign some forms. And today, Monday, I went to the dentist and they checked my teeth to make sure that as I will have to be intubated for the surgery, to make sure that none of my teeth might come loose and I might breathe them in, or any plaque or anything could come off my teeth and I might breathe it in. So apparently those things can cause pneumonia later on. So here in Japan, they decide to check your teeth first, and then I'll actually have my teeth checked afterwards as well to make sure that they weren't damaged by the intubation as well. So it's very interesting. I was very puzzled by the extra 5 days in hospital. I know that in Australia, it's quite common to be put into hospital either the night before or the day of surgery. So being here full 5 days before is kind of crazy, but I think it's good that they're this thorough. So positive things, although Japanese hospital food has got something to be desired. Leaves something to be said. I am not a big fan of rice for breakfast, so luckily from tomorrow morning, today the nutritionist came and I didn't think that I'd be able to change anything, but after talking to her, we're changing my breakfast tomorrow to bread and yogurt, which is much more my pace. I can handle Japanese food for lunch and dinner, but for breakfast, please give me bread and cereal or yogurt or something, so I'm very happy about that. Anyway, I'll leave it here for now and I will check in with you again later. Okay, see you again soon. Wish me luck. Today's the big day. Wish me luck. Just wanted to take a quick video. I'm okay, but I am in pain. Unfortunately, it's not cancer. Yay! It's not Friday. I had my surgery on Wednesday. Good news is, it wasn't cancerous. they removed it successfully. It does seem I have some sort of infection though. Something like TB or similar. So I've been put in my own room so as not to infect anybody else, just in case. I don't think it's TB, but there's a possibility it is. So until we know for sure, I'm here by myself. Which is fine with me, really. They keep telling me that I'll be better off in a shared room, but I'm not 100% sure about that. It has been interesting though, when I was in a shared room before, the nurses often used very strong dialect. 看護師さんめっちゃなまってる。で、多分それはおばあちゃん、おじいちゃんとよく話してるから余計なまってるかなと思うけど、個室になってそんなに方言話さなくなってる。面白いよね。 Anyway, catch you later. Today is Sunday, and as you can see, I'm doing a lot better.Started walking. My voice doesn't want to come out very well, but other than that, I'm doing good. Also, on the plus side, I don't have TB, tuberculosis. I have an infection from a bacteria that is similar but not the same, so that's also good.So I came home from hospital yesterday and I'm doing okay. The kids can get a bit rough, but Lily in particular, she's quite aware. So she's quite careful, and I just have to convince Emma and Isla to do the same. So I'm on a lot of pain meds, but other than that, I'm doing okay. I have a few quiet days at home before going back to work next week. Hello! It's now August.And about a month since I had my surgery. And as you can see, I'm looking and feeling a lot better. The other day, I had my follow-up checkup at the doctor's at the hospital, and I got the results of the tests that I had on what the tumor was caused by. So I have something kind of complicated. I think everyone knows what tuberculosis is. In Japanese, it's called kekkaku, but I don't have that, but I have something very closely related.To that. In English it's called non-tuberculous mycobacterial infection or something like that. In Japanese, hikkekkaku kousankin shou. For some reason I remember the Japanese better than the English because I live in Japan. I don't know. So we hope that all of the bacteria wasin the tumor, and by removing the tumor I've been cured. If I haven't been cured, then I will need ongoing treatment after this, but for now we can hope that I've been cured by surgery and that I won't have any problems moving forward. I will have to keep going back to the doctor to keep checking, but things look good at the moment, which is great. So I want to say a big thank you to everyone who helped me at the hospital. My doctors were really great, and the nurses as well. Particularly in Corona times, everything's a little bit different. Like in Japan, in Japanese hospitals, normally you go to the dining room in your ward to eat your meals and so on. But due to Corona, we all had to eat at our beds and things like that, which I'm sure put more pressure on the nurses. So.I want to say a big thank you to the nurses for looking after me and other people in the hospital, as well as also I want to say thank you to my rehabilitation specialist. It was very interesting in Japan to have rehab before and after, but very helpful as well. So I'm very thankful for that. So a big thank you to everyone at the hospital I was at, and also a big thank you to everyone around me, my friends, my family, and people at work who made sureThat I could take the time to go to hospital and get treated so quickly. I mentioned it in an earlier video, but I had my yearly checkup in May, got the results in June, had my surgery in July, so it was all very fast. which is another reason why we can hope that I am all better, I think. One interesting anecdote from when I was in hospital was, well, maybe not as funny. It's funny now, it wasn't funny at the time, was just after I got out of surgery, I was actually in quite a lot of pain. And I don't actually know why I know this word, but first of all, I said morphine in English because I wanted something for the pain. And then from somewhere in my brain, I dug out the Japanese word for it, which is morhine, which sounds slightly different. I don't know why I know that word, but apparently I do, and I remembered it when I needed it. So that worked out well. The doctors knew what I was talking about, and I was able to get some stronger pain medication not long after that. So that was really good. So that's end of anecdote one. あと、何? English or Japanese? So this year I was working really hard from January to lose the weight that I gained when I was pregnant with our three kids. So I had lost quite a lot of weight, but when I went into hospital, I lost quite a lot more weight while I was in hospital. I lost 3 or 4 kilos while I was away. And when I came back, everyone was very worried. You lost so much weight, are you okay? I'm okay. I want to say that I was originally trying to lose weight, so I don't think it's a bad thing, although it sort of seems that maybe I lost the weight so quickly that it makes me look sick, maybe, I don't know. But I'm doing good. I've kind of enjoyed being able to buy clothes in Japan that fit sort of, which is a new experience. So there are positives, silver lining to every cloud, so I'm doing fine.
How about that story about new jacket?
Oh yeah, my work jacket doesn't fit anymore. 何ヶ月前に仕事でジャケット、制服もらえるんですけど、前から持ってたやつが最初から大きくて、ちょっと大きすぎて、お客さんの前に着るのが恥ずかしくぐらい大きかったので、今年は食事管理をして、運動して、絞って、まあ、痩せてきたんですけど、それでもともと大きかった職場のジャケットがすごいブカブカになって、とてもお客さんの前に着れないぐらい大きい感じになってきて、ちょっとすいませんけど新しいものくださいって依頼して、4月頃に新しいものをもらいましたけど、退院してから復帰してジャケット着たらもうブカブカなっちゃって、さらになんか皆さん、なんか職場にいる人はなんかびっくりしてました。え、大丈夫、こんなジャケット大きいなっつって、でも我慢しなきゃいけない、最近もらったもんだから。洋服お直しのところを紹介してもらえれば嬉しいんだけどね。いい、それ、うん、When I was in hospital and when I got back to the ward, so I went from a small room, one person room, because there was concern that I had tuberculosis, to a group room. And after I got back thereI can't remember why, but for some reason Hiroshi sent me a video of the kids. This video here.
Mama.
Mama, I love you. Mama.
And I was watching it and it made me laugh. And after you've had lung surgery, not surprisingly, laughing hurts a lot. So I told him to be more careful after that, because...As much as I love funny videos of my kids, maybe they can wait till a little bit longer after I've had surgery.
入院してすぐぐらいの頃に、なんか子供たちのビデオ送ってとか言ってから、それからなんか定期的に送ってたんじゃ?
True. But, like, a regular video would have been fine. Why did it have to be a funny one?
Was it funny, but just normal video? And then some, for some reason, Lily starts saying.
Lily starts saying, thank you for watching, please like and subscribe, after every video ever. So it was really funny. it was really funny, and so I laughed, and so it hurt. Yup. So, because I was in hospital, last month we didn't manage to get out many videos, so apologies. Don't worry, we're still going. We're still going to keep putting out videos every week, so please stay tuned. Okay. Thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe. And don't worry about me. I'm okay.